Grace and peace be unto you from God our Father, the sweet Holy Spirit, and Jesus Christ, our risen Savior, and our soon coming King, who is the head of the church. I welcome you to another edition of the Boiler Room Prayer, and I am still thankful for the fact that Jesus is alive, and He is still on the throne. Amen. Good morning to each and every one of you. Where we are in Greensboro, North Carolina, it is bright and sunny, but from wherever you are watching, I send you the peace of God and the strength of God. And if you're watching this program, you have already been kissed by those twins, Grace and Mercy. And so I just bid you to give God a fresh praise this morning for waking you up. Hallelujah. For shining His face on your face. Glory to God. Amen. And I know not only will you be watching me from various locations, but out of various situations. Hallelujah. But I thank God that you had a mind to join us this morning for a Boiler Room Prayer. To the Citadel family, if you see somebody that's not on the line, go ahead and get in their business. Call them and text them and say, I don't see you. Amen. Type it in for those of you all who are virtual this morning. Glory to God. Check in. Let's have a virtual check-in this morning. Let's have a virtual praise session this morning. Glory to God as we endeavor to press into the presence of the Lord. And that is something that I just want to pull on you to help me to pull on the Holy Spirit this morning, that God would send His presence. Amen. That the angels of ministry and the presence of the Holy Spirit, oh, would invade our space and captivate our minds and saturate our soul this morning. Hallelujah. That God will give us the gift of His awesome presence. Hallelujah. And we know the Bible says in the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy. Oh my God. And I just want to talk to anybody that is stressed out, anybody that's strung out, people that are angry, people that are confused, people that are unsettled, and anyone that is watching me that is dealing with instability. I want you to know the fullness of joy is on its way to your household. The fullness of joy. If you invite it, if you connect with me, if you touch and agree with me, glory to God, fullness of joy is on its way to your heart and your mind. Fullness of joy is on its way to your spirit. Why? Because the presence of the Lord, oh, Holy Spirit of God, oh, my Lord, manifest yourself. Hallelujah. And we can't just say it and not worship the Lord for it. That's the quickest and the sure way, the most sure way to manifest the presence of the Lord. If you can find yourself in worship this morning, glory to God. If you can find yourself giving God His worth this morning, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. If you can find yourself adoring the Lord, and you may feel a little something in your body, you may be dealing with a little something in your mind, but if you can put that to the side, if you can press past that pain, I believe if the woman that had the issue of blood can get all the way to the revival and get down on all fours, then surely you can work beyond your stomach ache and beyond your headache and beyond your back ache and beyond your spirit ache. You can get past that long enough to tell God, thank you, and I love you. Thank you, and I praise you this morning. Thank you, Lord. Whatever it is I find myself in, glory to God. Amen. The scripture says, Paul said, whatever state of mind, glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, and I honor you this morning. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. If you can just have a heart and a mind of gratitude. We used to say it like this, an attitude of gratitude. I promise you, if you can worship the Lord, amen. And some of you all may have to take one step before you get to that step. You might have to say, I'm sorry. You might have to say, Lord, forgive me. You might have to say, Lord, I have sinned. You might have to admit, I should have done this 5 days ago. You might have to repent. You might have to come before the presence of the Lord and pour out so that God can fill in. Hanamashaya. Glory to your name. Lord, anyone and everyone who is watching me in that state right now, God, I just pray, Lord, that their minds will be strengthened and their hearts will be open, softened. I rebuke hard hearts and stubborn minds right now in the name of Jesus. Come on, tap in, tap in. If I shut down, tap in. Glory to God. Amen. Lord, I pray right now, glory to God, that your spirit, oh, would give us the courage to confront everything and anything that's binding, constricting evil spirits, snakes and scorpions running around our minds, sucking the life out of our soul. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke the work of the enemy. I rebuke the work of the enemy. Hallelujah. I rebuke spirits of infirmity, spirits that will cause you to be so sick that you can't focus on what it means to be well. In the name of Jesus, I'm already praying with people this morning who are fighting great warfare in their home this morning. Oh my God, the spirit of the fullness of joy, the spirit of the living God, manifest yourself. Hallelujah. In the midst of our adoration. Oh God, we call you holy. Come on, somebody. Just remind him how matchless he is. Remind the spirit of God how undefeated it is. Remind the throne of grace and the mercy seat how awesome and kind and loving and pure he is. We honor you this morning, God. Yes, Lord, we lift your name up. We call you the wonderful one. We call you King of Kings, risen, resurrected, alive Savior. We call you the living Word. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. God, we call you holy, holy, holy. You are the only supreme. You are the almighty. No one's strength can compare. I am a seer. A stroke of your finger can correct any and everything that's beneath the heavens. It don't even require all of your strength, Lord. But we adore you this morning. 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 I just want to make some demons mad. I just want to make depression mad. Yeah, I just want to make addiction upset. Hayamasa. Glory, glory, glory. We adore you this morning. Hallelujah. We worship you. Glory to God. You said, they that worship me must worship me in spirit and in truth. So, Lord, forgive us for every sin. Forgive us for all of the iniquity. Forgive us, God, for even getting to 6, 7, 8, 9 o'clock in the morning and not being grateful. Hallelujah, Lord. Forgive us for coming on the prayer, not ready to contribute, Lord. Hallelujah, but just listening, God. I pray right now that people would turn their listening into activity. Hallelujah, that people's faith would come alive. Hallelujah, that people would not only hear the prayer and receive the prayer, but they'll send the prayer. Hallelujah, they'll demonstrate prayer. They'll reflect prayer this morning. But God, we pray right now, Lord, that your grace and your mercy Lord, will forgive us for every one of our faults as we desire and we endeavor to come into your presence. Somebody's coming on here with a lot of guilt this morning. Well, I want you to just give it over. Just turn it over. Just turn it over. Turn it over. Hallelujah. With a lot of anger, turn it over. Turn it over in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Build your altar. Glory to God. Build your altar. Go and grab a candle and light it. Just light a candle and say, this is the presence of the Holy Spirit. Glory to God. Amen. You don't need no artifacts, no ornaments. You don't need no smoke, no nothing. Glory to God. Just say, Lord, this is a symbol of your presence. Glory to God. Holy Spirit, come on in. Come on in. Come on in. Come on in. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God, because this worship is getting ready to clear and clean and cleanse, and it's getting ready to bring the Spirit of the Lord into place. And when the Spirit of the Lord comes, hallelujah, there's so much work that can be done in the Spirit. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Lord, we pray that you light the fire in the bowling room this morning.
Yes, hallelujah.
Amen. We've already been praying, glory to God, as we prepared to come on live to you this morning. We've already been praying, glory to God, but we ask the Holy Spirit to just light the fire. Light the fire. Light the fire. We will bring the sacrifice if you provide the fire. And listen, I don't care how much the enemy does not want you to experience the presence of God this morning. Amen. Glory to God. The false prophets prayed all day and all night that their God would light the fire, and they couldn't get it done. But the prophet of God, hallelujah, glory to God, said, bring me some water. And I want you to soak, and I want you to saturate everything that God's getting ready to light up. Amen. I want you to see that it is humanly impossible to do what only God can do. And then he said, bring me some more water. Bring me some more water. I want it to be clear, hallelujah, because you know water is what consumes fire, hallelujah. But when it's real, when you got the real thing, huh? When it's not a fire made by man's hands, but it's a fire lit by the power of heaven, it's undeniable. And it's unstoppable. And we know then, right then, the Holy Spirit lit up, glory to God, the sacrifice. And I'm praying this morning that if you bring God sacrifice, and I don't care how impossible it seems, I don't care how mighty, I don't care how much, glory to God, it seems like it can't be consumed. It seems like it's hard to be delivered. And I just want you to bring God the sacrifice.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And I pray that in the name of Jesus, the Holy Spirit, glory to God, amen, will provide the fire, not made by our hands. Glory to God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. We welcome you to the boiler room this morning. Perhaps you have prayer requests. And I encourage you to send them. I encourage you to allow us to touch and agree with you this morning on every prayer request. 336-898-9946. That is our prayer request text line. I pray that you'll send them on. Glory to God, that you'll allow us the opportunity to touch and agree with you. I'm not going to ask the prayer cast how they're doing this morning. I'm just going to encourage them to go straight into, amen, the shower of scriptures, beginning with Sister Shaquela. Good morning to you, Sister Shaquela. Where are you taking us in the word of the Lord this morning?
Good morning. I'll be coming from Psalm 147, verses 1-9.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, God. And it reads, hallelujah. How good it is to sing to our God, for our praise is pleasant and lovely. The Lord rebuilds Jerusalem. He gathers Israel's exiled people. He heals the brokenhearted and bandages their wounds. He counts the number of stars. He gives names to all of them. Our Lord is great, vast in power. His understanding is infinite. The Lord helps the oppressed, but brings the wicked to the ground. Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. Play the lyre to our God, who covers the sky with clouds. He prepares rain for the earth and causes grass to grow on the hills. He provides the animals with their food and the young ravens what they cry for.
Thank you so much, Psalm 147. Brother Timothy, good morning to you. Welcome to the Boiler Room Prayer Broadcast. Where are you taking us this morning?
Good morning. We're going to Isaiah 30. We'll start at verse 18. It says, "So the Lord must wait for you to come to him, so he can show you his love and compassion. For the Lord is a faithful God.
Hallelujah.
Blessed are those who wait for his help. O people of Zion, who live in Jerusalem, you will weep no more. He will be gracious if you ask for help. He will surely respond to the sound of your cries. Though the Lord gave you adversity for food and suffering for drink, he will still be with you to teach you. You will see your teacher with your own eyes. Your own ears will hear him. Right behind you, a voice would say, 'This is the way that you should go,' whether to go to the right or to the left. Then you will destroy all your silver idols and your precious gold images. You will throw them out like filthy rags, saying to them, 'Good riddance.'"
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Minister Woodrell Gilchrist, good morning and welcome to the Boiler Room Prayer.
Good morning. I'm going to be reading from Romans 16, verses 17 through 20. "Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them. For they that are such serve not our Lord Jesus Christ, but their own belly, and by good words and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple. For your obedience is come abroad unto all men. I am glad therefore on your behalf, but yet I would have you wise unto that which is good and simple concerning evil. And the God of peace shall bruise Satan under your feet shortly. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen."
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. That validates where the devil is. He's subjected to my very foot, the sole under my feet. The power of Satan belongs right there. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Sometimes when I praise the Lord in my dancing and in my shouting and my rejoicing, I'm reminded of that. He's under my feet. The scripture said that I could not just dance, but I can inflict harm. I can bruise him.
Jesus.
Somebody ought to renew your praise. With that understanding, glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Come on, Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Brother Walker, where are you taking us this morning?
Like my brother Tim, I am also going to the prophet Isaiah 43, verse 1, and it reads, "But now this is what the Lord says, he who created you, Jacob, he who formed you, Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have summoned you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. And when you walk through the fire, you will not be burned, and the flames will not set you ablaze." That was Isaiah 43, 1 through 2.
Hallelujah. Amen. No matter where you find yourself, glory to God. The Lord said, you will not be as consumed Amen. I'll be with you. I'll be your lifeline. I'll be your raft. Hallelujah. I'll be your shield and your shade and your covering. Amen. Psalm 16, the 16th Psalm says, preserve me, O God, for in you do I put my trust. O my soul, you have said unto the Lord, you are my Lord. My goodness extends not to you, but to the saints who are in the earth, and to the excellent, in whom is all my delight. Their sorrows shall be multiplied, who hasten after another God. Their drink offerings of blood will I not offer, nor take up their names unto my lips. The Lord is the portion of my inheritance and of my cup. You maintain my lot. The lines have fallen unto me in the pleasant places. Yes, I have a goodly heritage. I will bless the Lord who has given me counsel. My reins also instruct me in the night season. I've set the Lord always before me, because he is at my right hand. I shall not be moved. Therefore, my heart is glad, and my glory rejoices. And my flesh also shall rest in hope. For you will not leave my soul in hell, neither will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You will show me the path of life. In your presence is fullness of joy. And at thy right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. The word of God for the people of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen. This psalm cast down idol worship. Cast down the evil influence of the enemy. It cast down the very notion that I will not be saved. It cast down the enemy's work around me and in me. It lets us to know hell is not my home. And therefore, I want to just encourage you all, if you're dealing with hell in your home, get it out. It don't belong there. It does not belong there. Glory to God. It does not belong there. Amen. I speak to every principality. I speak to every persistence. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You've been crying more than you've been smiling. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God, I rebuke hell out of your home. Hallelujah. Out of your literal home and your spiritual home. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. A glad heart. He said, I've set the Lord always before me in verse 8, because he is at my right hand and I shall not be moved. Therefore, my heart is glad. Sometimes we got to put God right back in this place. Yeah, yeah. Amen. You're quick to say, I haven't left the church. I haven't left God, but is he before you? Is he a guiding light? Uh-huh. your humanity. My flesh also rests in hope. And this is dealing with the spirit of depression and the spirit of oppression, the spirit of sadness, and the spirit of defeat and the spirit of doubt. That's what causes hope to leave your heart. In the absence of hope, what do you have? And you know the enemy, glory to God, is trying to take that hell and remove your hope. Oh, but in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Oh, my God. Come on, son. Come on, daughter. In Jesus' name, I want you to reclaim your virtue. I want you to reclaim your praise. I want you to reclaim your power. Glory to God. As you release it, the Holy Spirit said, I'll help you get it back. Come on now.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. I know you got your plans. Hallelujah. But I just come on here to be a disruptor this morning. Hallelujah. That's what the Holy Spirit is doing. Glory to God. Amen. You got to have a lot of courage to get into prayer. Amen. You can talk to God about all your problems, but what if God starts talking to you about you being the problem? Hallelujah. And I want you to get your glory and your power and your virtue back. And I want you to get hell out your heart and your home. In the name of Jesus, God, help somebody. Glory to God. That God, help somebody push into this, to lean into this, to press into this. Glory to God. Give them courage in the midst of this so that hell will not be our home. In the name of Jesus. And if you can do this, if you can invite the Son, look at, he said, you will not leave my soul in hell, neither will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. In other words, God wants to resurrect us the same way he resurrected Jesus out of the grave. Glory to God. He wants to bring us out of the darkness and back into the marvelous light. You will show me the path of life. For everyone that is realizing, when I make this decision, now I got to deal with this outcome. If I do, if I change this, if I rearrange it, if I actually, glory to God, if I start releasing the hell, what about my next step? What about my money? Huh? What about my friendships? We close. Come on, somebody. What about my relationships? What am I going to do with me? The scripture says he will show you the path of life. And everything that's talking to us is showing us every other path. Huh? The path to money. Huh? The path to fame. Huh? The path to prosperity. Huh? The path. You got a path to education. You got people pressing their way towards graduation right now. And we're not going to let nothing stop us, especially when it's close. Oh, God, but what profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? Somebody ask the Lord, show me the path to life.
Show me the path to life.
I don't want to just breathe. I want to live. And I'm not just talking about existence. I'm talking about new life. I'm talking about show me the path to eternal life. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost, show me the path that will release my mind to peace and heal my body from pain. Show me the path that will put me in my purpose. so I cannot be addicted to my pleasures. Show me the path to life.
Hallelujah.
And the scripture bids you to come into the presence of the Lord right there. Right there. In the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy, and there are pleasures at the right hand of God forevermore. Lord, we bombard heaven this morning. We bombard heaven. Somebody's in shackles. Somebody's in chains. Somebody's in doubt. Somebody's in pain. Somebody is in confusion. And somebody, and the Holy Spirit really, really, really presses this upon me right now. Somebody is afraid. Fear has disrupted your living. God, for every principality and every relative, every cousin and every kin demon, I pray in Jesus' name that the kingdom of hell will begin to lose its power, lose its grip. I pray in Jesus' name, Lord, that your beauty and your presence and your awesomeness and your love and even a fragrance from heaven will begin to saturate somebody's heart, fill their nostrils. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. I see somebody, your healing is going to come by your breathing in this morning. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Get it in you. Get it in you. Hallelujah. The Lord works in mysteries like that. Glory to God. Amen. The Lord works in mysteries. The fragrance of God can kill cancer. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Every time you inhale, glory to God, when the Lord is in the room, now you're taking the Holy Spirit in. And every time you exhale, you letting every demon and every devil out. And you ought to say, I rebuke you and I renounce you right now. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. Hallelujah. I encourage you, Dabashaya, Holy Spirit, to come in and take presence, take up space. Glory to God. Fill us, fill us, fill our cup. Fill our cup. Fill our cup. Glory to God. Hallelujah. David talks about that cup overflowing. Lord, fill our cup this morning. Hallelujah. Maybe somebody hasn't truly gotten into prayer and intercession in so long because the enemy has stolen their joy, stolen their virtue, stolen their glory. Well, I come today to restore and reclaim my virtue and my glory. In the name of Jesus. I'm praying for somebody this morning. I'm interceding. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm trying to deliver you back to God. I'm trying to deliver you back to God. Now, the enemy done tricked some people from not even getting on this broadcast this morning. Glory to God. But for those of you all that had a little bit of mind and courage to get in here and stay in here, glory to God, I come to tell you the Holy Spirit is in the room now. The fullness of joy. I told you it was coming. The fullness of joy. Glory to God. Amen. I want to encourage somebody to take the alcohol and flush it down the drain. Glory to God. Glory to God. Take the drugs. Glory to God. And put them in the toilet and flush it down. Glory to God. Take your sex toys. Glory to God. And destroy them. Glory to God. And any artifact and any remnant of your past, glory to God, anything that's in the way of your deliverance, glory to God, hallelujah. And I tell you something, if we could destroy these phones and these tablets and these computers, Lord, if we didn't need them for work and we didn't need them, glory to God, amen, to connect with our business and so on and so forth. But you know what? God, purify our hearts and our minds. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, God, give us courage to close the accounts. Give us courage, Lord, to fight back. Amen. I want to encourage you, my friend. Fight back. I want to encourage you to get your soldier self. Don't lay down to it. Don't lay down to it. I want to encourage you to get your fight back. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Some people are, you've been fighting and you got weary. Glory to God. I encourage you to ask the Lord, renew my strength. I can't stay tired. Glory to God. I can't stay this way. Glory to God. I got to get my mind back in the fight. Hallelujah. Victory is certain. It's imminent. I said victory is on your side. Glory to God. But I want you to let the devil know, you know what? I'm not staying on this road. I'm not staying on this road. Anabashaya. And you can't stay here. Taking my time with this morning. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because God's trying to get a work done.
Hallelujah. Do it, oh God.
Hallelujah. 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 Glory. 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 In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Dabasha. Hallelujah. Will you worship the Lord with me this morning? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm thinking about Psalm 51. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thinking about Psalm 51. Have mercy on me, O Lord, according to your loving kindness, according to the multitude of your tender mercies, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Here's the repentance. For I acknowledge my transgression, and my sin is ever before me. Against you, and you only have I sinned. And some of us can't say that now. You sinned against your family. You sinned against your purpose. But this is what David said. Behold, I was shaped in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Behold, you desire truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part you shall make me to know wisdom. I can't rush past that. Behold, you desire truth in the inward part. Come on, somebody that's dealing with a spirit of insincerity. You have been in church, but the church still ain't in you. You got a position in church, but you're out of position in glory. You have played with this purpose. It's important when you have to do it. And when you don't have to do it, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, the truth is not emanating from you. David said, you desire truth in the inward parts of me. In the inward parts of me. And in the hidden part, you shall make me to know wisdom. The Lord is getting some work done this morning. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. And I just thought about how when it's time for us to take a drug test, we want to be clean and we want to be clear. Oh, my. You know, when it's time for us to be grooms and brides, we want to be clean. When it's time for our photo shoots, when it's time for us to be cute, we want to be clean. It's time for us to be holy. It's time for us to be delivered. Ask the Lord to purge you. Wash you. Hallelujah. See, look now. Now let's deal with your heart. Make me to know, make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones which you have broken may rejoice. I don't have time to. Psalm 51 is always a revival in and of itself. Make me to hear joy and gladness. First of all that secular music stirring up in your mind, get it out. It's time for you to stray from that playlist. You need to hear joy and gladness. And all the messages that don't have anything to do with the prosperity of God's work in your life, there's no gladness, there's no joy in that. I don't care. Stop letting the devil work you through a beat. If you can't get delivered from a beat, you'll never get delivered from cigarettes and alcohol. If you can't get delivered from the sound of a beat, you'll never get delivered from lies and lust. Come on, somebody. You mean a beat has that much control over you? And we know how that stuff works. It talks about so much love and talks about so much, you know, soul music. Look how the enemy working on the soul through the soul music. And when I finish listening to soul music, will my soul live in heaven? Oh, my God. Come on, somebody. Look how the enemy, you know, is working on that. I want you to know, you got to get your hearing right. Make me to hear joy. Hallelujah. Make me to hear gladness. Thank you, Lord. Somebody needs to turn on joy music so you can deal with your angry spirit. You need to learn a new song. Glory to God, an anointed song. And some of it you can't even find on YouTube. It's the songs that you used to hear when we didn't have a whole lot of bands and a whole lot of microphones. We just hollered out, I get joy when I think about what he's done for me. That's what you need to sing all day long. Hallelujah. Hide your face. Look at the shame. Hide your face from my sins. Blot out all my iniquities. Create in me. What led me here was that you desire truth in my inward parts. Create in me a clean heart, oh God. And renew a right spirit in me. You could just reach out your hand and touch and agree with me this morning. Somebody's getting saved. You can't wait till the service tomorrow. You just reach out your hand and touch and agree with me this morning. That there will be a revival in your heart and your mind and your soul. And a revival is a renewal. It is a reviving. God, I pray that for everyone that is pressing into this intercession this morning, and we're right there. God, somebody's heart has been stolen from relationship with you. Somebody's heart is tangled up and bound up in something that will not lead to joy and gladness and salvation. God, somebody's heart is so bent on another love that it's in a broken state instead of it desiring your love. Lord, renew. Renew. We have poured so much energy into so many other things that we have strayed away from right relationship, from right decisions, from making the righteous plans, from going down the righteous path. God, I pray this morning for everyone who is begging you for help, for everyone who is hearing this scripture and saying, this is me. This is not just David. This is me now. Renew, create in me a clean heart, oh God, and renew the right spirit in me. You ought to say that. Say that to the Lord. Say it to the Lord. Amen. I'm reciting it, but you got to say it and mean it. Say it in faith. I know some of you scared of what this means. Glory to God. But what you don't realize is that the enemy will have you scared of making changes, but not scared to die, scared to die the way you are if you stay the same. Tomorrow is not promised. There's too many car wrecks and freak accidents and active shooters around for you to think that you got another day and another week and another month and another season. You don't have a hot summer. Glory to God. You need to ask the Lord for a holy summer. Have a hot summer to play with. Create in me. A clean heart, oh God. Shende Asaya. Glory to God. My pursuit for things, my pursuit to look better, my pursuit to, you know, be stronger, my pursuit to, you know, build my physique and not my spirit, my pursuit, glory to God, to adorn myself with all of these ornaments, my pursuit, glory to God, to have these letters behind my name, my pursuit, God, to create an image that looks like I'm living large and looks like I have a wonderful family, my pursuit. Yes. Glory to God for love in all the wrong ways and all the wrong spaces has caused a dirty heart. It has caused a dirty spirit. It has caused a nasty mentality. It has caused me to prioritize my pleasures and the things that I feel like I gotta have to validate who I feel like I wanna be and I should be by now. Glory to God, I ask you, Lord, to purge me and help renew my consciousness. Glory to God, creating me a clean heart. I used to love to love you. I used to love to worship you. I used to love to serve you. Glory to God. And then I see you. Glory to God, I used to be the one pressing my way to boiler room. Glory to God, when I had to get dressed and get in my car and drive to it, and now I'm hesitating on rolling out of bed and sitting up and taking it in. Hold up, Ashaya. Say that I come to serve notice on you this morning. I come to serve notice on your corruption. I come to serve notice on your plan. I come to serve notice on your tricks. I come to serve notice on all your craftiness. I come to serve notice in our children. Oh, God, but our children will be delivered. Glory to God, our children, hallelujah. God, God will be saved. Glory to God, but there are children praying for their parents this morning. The Holy Spirit, I see you. Glory to God, hallelujah. And I touch and agree with your son. I touch and agree with your daughter. I touch and agree with you right now. Glory to God that the power of God is present to deliver. Thank you, Jesus, right now. Glory to God for every heart that is open, for every heart that is soft, for every stubborn spirit that's losing its power. Glory to God, and losing the spirit of pride is being cast down in every stronghold, in every strong spirit, in every strong man. Glory to God is being, glory to God, overcome. It's being overpowered. That's all you got to do and keep doing is just saying Jesus. All you got to do is just keep worshiping the Lord, Holy One of God. Glory to God, God of Jacob, God of Isaac. Glory to God, God of Abraham, God of my life. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh. Glory to God, create in me a clean heart. Hallelujah. Purge me with hyssop and I shall be clean. Wash me and I shall be whiter than snow in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I don't want to stay like this and I don't want to die like this. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And I rebuke death. I rebuke death. And accept the Lord call you. Glory to God. You deaf angel. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You spirit of suicide. Hallelujah. You spirit of eviction. You spirit of addiction. Glory to God. Some of you all, you might not be taking a gun and a knife to your veins and to your temple. Glory to God. But you're letting drugs drag you down in a pit. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You're letting your liver shrivel up. Glory to God, because you keep playing with all the addictions. Glory to God, and you're digging yourself in a grave with a knife and a fork behind depression. Glory to God, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. I come against the spirit of dying and decay. I come against the spirit of mental instability. I come against the spirit of schizophrenia. I come against the spirit that is grappling with our minds. Glory to God in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I invite you into my heart to be my Lord and my Savior. And I ask you to forgive me for every one of my sins and my iniquities. And I ask you to purge me, Lord, so that you can then cleanse me, so that you can then begin rebuilding and renewing the right spirit. Somebody's been complaining more than you've been praising. Glory to God. You have more questions. Glory to God than you have a quest. Oh, the Lord said, ask, seek, and knock, and the door shall be opened unto you. Glory to God. And in the spirit realm this morning, glory to God, the door of heaven is wide open. Hallelujah, the door to deliverance in the name of Jesus. And I just want somebody just to believe God for deliverance right now. I know you come to the altar time and time again. See, that's why you got to keep seeking. You got to keep seeking. It is the will of the Lord. It is the will of the Lord for you to be healed. It is the will of the Lord for you to be sane. Dabashika. Hey, hey, hey. And somebody is, I want to. The enemy has, by way of substance abuse, by way of trauma, by way of rejection, by way of shame, the enemy has taken our sanities. But I pronounce over you a restoration of your stable mind. I rebuke this spirit of insanity. The audible shot. God, I pray right now that it'll be broken. I rebuke the spirit of insanity. I rebuke the form of godliness. Don't you deny this power, because the Lord has come to restore your mind. He kanabasia. The Lord is trying to do it, baby. I promise you, there's no medicine that can get it done at this point. The Holy Ghost is the medicine. Lord, you can perform miracles. And I believe the Lord this morning, this is a miracle broadcast this morning. I believe that this is a miracle broadcast this morning. God, give me a miracle in my mind. Somebody need to say it and say it again. Hallelujah. This is your prayer for the next 21 days. God, give me a miracle in my mind. Glory to God. I used to be able to produce thoughts. My capacity was greater. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. My intelligence and my wisdom and my discernment. Glory to God. My memory. In the name of Jesus. And God, I pray that you would give the person whose mind has been fried up and eaten up, glory to God, by substance abuse, glory to God, whose mind has been smoked out. And in the name of Jesus, glory to God, hallelujah, the enemy, glory to God, did what he did. But God, you are a restorer. Glory to God, you can restore and you can renew. Surely, if you can raise a dead body, glory to God, and put life back in dead organs and a heartbeat back in a dead heart, surely you can speak life to our minds. Shabbasia, in the name of Jesus, you can get it done. You can get it done. I pray right now that miracle work in mind, glory to God, altering. If you can change the heart of men, you can certainly deliver the mind of your sons and your daughters. And I pray this morning in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Some of you all are so offended. Glory to God, your mind has not been able to release it. Glory to God. But I come to tell you right now, the oil of God is easing the offenses out of your mind. God, anoint us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The oil of God is easing that tension. The oil of God is easing that anger. Hallelujah. It's got to go. In the name of Jesus, it's got to go. It's got to go. It's got to go. And I feel like a dredging. I feel it moving. Glory to God. You've been like a pipe that's been stopped up. Glory to God. But in the name of Jesus, I feel a deluge of pain and insecurity and trauma. Yes, I feel it. I feel it. I know you are a legitimate victim, but I also know that if you don't forgive, that you cannot be forgiven. In the name of Jesus. And I'm talking to somebody that's also up in age. How am I seeing? I'm talking to a stubborn spirit that's been there for a long time. I'm talking to a spirit, glory to God, amen, that's been working on your mind, a spirit of anger. Glory to God. The Holy Spirit said, cast down bitterness. Cast down bitterness. I'm trying to heal somebody from bitterness. Glory to God, which means it's some roots, it's some bitter roots. Glory to God, they got to come up and they got to come out in the name of Jesus. I proclaim it done right now. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Maybe you tuned in late. Maybe you tuned in 2 weeks late. This prayer does not expire. Glory to God, this prayer is not for a day. This prayer is for a decade. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. And if you ever feel the things that God is delivering you from in this hour trying to come back upon you, I pray that you'll bookmark this prayer. Glory to God, I pray that you'll favorite this broadcast. Glory to God, I pray that you will chronicle this prayer. I pray that it will be available to you in the day and the midnight hour. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. And for everyone, Lord, that you are working on, and for every process and every deliverance that's starting in this hour, glory to God, it's got to continue tomorrow. It's got to continue the day after that, and the week after that, and the month after that. I pray, God, that we'll hold on to this victory. I pray, God, that we'll hold on to this. back into your household, into your heart and your mind. Glory to God, I started this broadcast, hallelujah, by letting you know that fullness of joy was coming. Fullness of joy. Glory to God, it's being delivered to you faster than Amazon Prime can get you your next order. That fullness of joy is standing at your door. Fullness of joy, glory to God, is coming through the threshold of your heart and your mind in the name of Jesus. And I know some of you all may be in serious situations, glory to God, but I pray right now from the pit of the prison, glory to God, and the bed of infirmity, hallelujah, I pray right now somebody is in trouble, glory to God, but I come to tell you right now that joy is getting ready to invade your heart and your mind. That there's going to be a release, glory to God, in the spirit first, glory to God, and therefore it'll manifest itself in the natural, in the name of Jesus. And I praise the Lord for this privilege this morning, this day. I thank you, God, that you saved me to help somebody else. Glory to God. I thank you this morning that even when depression came for the prophet, God, it had to turn right back around and go back to hell in the name of Jesus. Glory to God, I thank you right now, hallelujah, amen, for every vessel, every disciple, every witness. And I pray, God, that you will restore every pastor and every evangelist, every prophet, every teacher, and every apostle. Glory to God, hallelujah. I pray right now, Lord, that there will be people that will return back to the household of faith. Glory to God, hallelujah. Did he all shun down? You got to get back to your place of power in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I pray right now that people are come running. I mean, come ready and running. That hearts will be right, God. Hallelujah. And I pray right now that every pastor that's believing you, every apostle that's believing you for help to get through another weekend of worship and another weekend of serving you and serving the people of God, I pray in Jesus' name, God, that there will be help from the Holy Spirit. Yes. Lord, we are still celebrating your resurrection. Jesus, you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Take shape in our life. Captivate our hearts and our minds and our soul. Devil, that hotel just got bulldozed. A whole community in hell just got bulldozed. That retirement home you built, I don't need it no more. My soul will not stay in hell. Somebody is being delivered, being set free. There's a miracle in the midst of you right now. Thank you, Lord. And hallelujah to your holy name. This has been the Boiler Room Prayer. Stay on the wall. Stay strengthened. Stay encouraged. If this broadcast has blessed you and you can get to the Citadel Church tomorrow, we worship at 3 o'clock. If you can't get to the Citadel, you can still get to a church. Ask the Holy Spirit to lead you and guide you into all truth. I want to encourage you all to press your way. Amen. I want to encourage you to sow a seed. Amen. Be serious. If you're serious about this change, you're serious about this, serious about this deliverance, and I want you to open your treasure. And I want you to send the broadcast a seed this morning. And it's for you. It's because where your treasure is where your heart also is. And you're serious. You're saying, you know what, God? I want to symbolize that this is not just a moment. I want to put a seed in the ground. I want to encourage you to do that this morning. And lastly, I just want to encourage you to be encouraged. I encourage you this morning. Don't give up. You're on the brink of a breakthrough. God bless you. grace, mercy, and peace be unto you.